Look at here. I log into your application. What is the application? STFMR. Thread admin. Maybe this is required for you, the understanding about binary files. After this, I'll talk about maybe some other rules if required. See, if you wanted to add an image in the user interface, suppose I wanted to include an image in my UI. If you go to advanced, here you have something related to image. Where is it? Not here. Basic. Image is there. Icon is there and something related to image is there. This simple icon. Maybe this is one second one. Autocomplete. Signature capture, rich textures, much video. Okay, let's go on with this one. What is it? Icon. So if you add an icon, icon means it should be an image file, right? If you click on this, it is going to ask you the icon source should be there. Standard icon, hypertext is okay, disable is okay. Image. Here you can go and choose image. If you choose image, it is going to ask you an image. Here, what to be passed. So you must have to go ahead and, for this image to be passed, you might have to go ahead and create a binary file group. So generally, let me show you this using the OOTP feature in Pega, how it is implemented in BRPC itself. If you just go ahead and open manager portal, right? When you open manager portal, see, you have dashboard, you have my work, pulse, spaces. Does all these have images included? Suppose if I wanted to debug to see what rules are being used to design and implement this, how to debug and see? You have to go through live UI. Where is it? This is the one, live UI. So when you go to live UI, you just mouse over on this and just open it the menu. Maybe there are different images. It's not only this one. Here also Pega is an image icon, right? This one also you can open and see. It's up to you what you wanted to open and see, but you should be able to debug it easily when you go through the predefined one. See here, if you open this icon, so here it is being referenced by a property, logo reference something. They're doing it by a property reference. Okay, leave about property reference, which we'll not be understanding. So let's go ahead with this one. The second menu I am going to get into. When you go through the second menu, you remember we have added an image previously, right? My work or something, whatever that you wanted to get into, you can get in. So here you have an image icon, which is PY flag or something. This is what we have added, right? By ourselves. Image source, you have icon class. And click the down arrow or something. Which one? Create customer we have added, right? Not here. I believe we have added somewhere. Presentation. Advanced settings is not the one. So whatever that you see here, PI flag is there, right? Let me search for it. It's not coming. All applications. Not able to search. Let me go ahead and go to technical category and show you. Let me go ahead and show you binary file. This is a binary file. Let me open and show you. You'll be able to understand. See, if you create a rule called binary file, this is help. Something is there. Let me open this. In this binary file rule, you see here upload file and download file. Let me download this file, which is already available in my application. What is this? It is some file which is related to, it is .svg file, which is related to, maybe it is upload feature, something like that. We'll take one meaningful file name, create down calendar date time. This is also SVG, right? Okay, let me show you JPG. You have PNG, GIF is there, right? JIF, error triangle, or you have PNG. You can choose any one of these so that you can better understand. Let me download this and save the file And here you go with open this and see the preview of this. This is just related to images. That's why I'm just concentrating on images. Where is it? Preview. So this is one of the image. You cannot see this. It is because it doesn't have any colors. It says predictive analytics director. Something is there. If you cannot see that, let me read out. I will download another image also and show you so that you can better understand. Here you go. PNG related PYT score model. Something is there. Download this file. This is also not, it doesn't have any colors. Let me see if something has some color and all. Okay, this one you can see. Open with something. Okay, so this is one of the image, PNG image. See, these images might have been used somewhere in PRPC environment. If you wanted to go ahead and add an image, you will not be directly adding an image as an image. You cannot copy paste into your section rules, which is not possible. So instead, what you have to do is you have to create binary files. You need to create a binary file rule and then upload your image to binary file. Wherever you wanted to go ahead and refer this image, you have to refer this with the binary file rule name. Then it is going to appropriately load the image. While you upload the images, images should go into any specific folder path. So that folder path is WebWB. WebWB is the folder path where in which your images gets stored. Let me go ahead here. Let me try to find out where let it get searched. Okay, so when you upload the file, it will go into WebWB. While you are referring accordingly, you have to refer the WebWB. So now let me go ahead and save as this to show you. If I save as this, these are the parameters while you are creating new image. One is the label. Whatever the label that you wanted to give, you can give. It's up to you. And app directory name. Directory name means it should be a folder path, right? Generally, 99.99% whatever that you create for images, it's 99.99. It is 100%. You will go with the folder path is WebWB. And file type extension. What is the file type extension? PNG. Or it can be GIF or it can be JPEG or something. It depends on what type of file you're uploading. If it is not matching, it won't accept it. Okay. So accordingly, you have to go ahead and provide the name of the extension of the file and the directory of the folder. Look at here. Let it get opened. Okay. So into the web directory of into the directory WebWB, these images will be uploaded. Whenever you refer these binary files into your user interface, the images will be displayed in the UI accordingly. Okay. So let me go ahead and show you how to create a binary file rule. The best approach to create a binary file rule is you can open one of the binary file rule. Look at here. This is JPG. If I open this, I can just go ahead and save as this. When you save as this, it will automatically show you the extension. The same extension you want when you want it to upload and same app directory you want. And the name of the file that you wanted to go ahead and give is text analytics icon. Okay, so then it will be creating, it will be creating the binary file rule. You'll be able to upload an image with this name. This is clear. Let's go ahead and upload an image. What we have, suppose if I want an image to be like this, what is the type of this image? This is the image that I have. And here I go ahead and see the properties. This is a JPG file. I want a JPG extension file to be uploaded and creating by for creating a binary file rule. So you just go ahead here and open one of the binary file rule and then create it. Let me go ahead and document the same first of all to work with images. Okay, let me show you. Okay, with images we need to create. Or I'll write down this way to include images into sections. We need to create binary file rule and use. Previously, we used to have a control called image. Let me check that and use image control. Okay, let me check that whether it is available or not. Okay. A binary file rule can be created under which category? Technical category. Under technical category. So using binary file rule, we can upload different types of files. We are talking about images. First of all, images, comma. What are the other files? Excel, XML. See, if you want to design templates of your Excel processing and all, you have to go ahead and create Excel documents as binary file rule and refer the binary file means you are referring to Excel template. When you have image related binary file, you refer binary file means you are referring to image. When you have an exe file uploaded, if you are referring to binary file, you are referring to exe file, something like that. So, etc. Here you go ahead. Now, how to create a binary file rule to upload a JPG or any extension of images? Okay, this is clear. So let me go ahead and show you that. So the best approach is open one of the ODB binary file rule related to JPG extension, comma, save as to create a new one. For storing images. If you look at here, WebWB is purely meant for images mainly, and zip files, CSV files also they are loading. And for some other Excel files, they are using a different path. But it's not about the path. It's up to you which folder path you wanted to choose. 100 out of 100% will use always WebW path for your Excel document template uploads, for your images upload and all. Excel document, I'll teach you maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Okay. How to upload Excel templates and read the content from Excel and process it. It is already available in PDN. If you have such interest, you can, you should be able to learn by yourself. Otherwise, I will show you. Okay. Everywhere it is same, real time also. Okay, let me go ahead and show you that from the beginning. Close all this and go to records tab and click on binary file. Go to records tab and click on binary file. Okay, so open one of the binary file, open one of the binary file rules which are created with extension JPG. Okay, let me open that and show you. So you can find out this, otherwise you can just go ahead with filter and extension and just type JPG and apply. It will display only something related to JPG. You can open one of those. Okay, it's up to you. I think I'm not required to give the screenshot related to search filter, right? See, let me ask you one question. Suppose if I am going to save as this binary file rule as it is with the same name into my own rule set and upload a different image here, what happens? Wherever this image is being used in the processing of PRBS environment, your new image will come. You need to find out the image related to Pega logo. Top left corner you have Pega logo, right? I wanted to change that to my own office company logo. Okay, whenever I am displaying a portal, manager portal, left side top you will see Pega logo, right? Let's see. I want to change it to my company logo. What should I do? You need to find out that logo rule, which rule is being used, and upload a new image into that, whatever your office logo, it will override that. You must have to restart the server, I believe. Okay, maybe, I'm not very much sure. Now just open this and then save as this. So when you save as, let me go ahead and give the name of the image. Same name I'm going to choose the image name here just for practice purpose. Here you go ahead and do the trainings give a different name. Okay, and WebWP directory and JPG format, that is fair enough. And I'm creating it in framework level. Okay, and organization tool set so that it will be available everywhere, wherever I want to use it. Create and open. So when you create and open, it will ask you the image file. What is the image file that I wanted to upload? Upload a new image file. So let me go ahead and upload it. Upload file. And here you go with desktop. This is the one which I thought of giving, right? Choose your image here. Suppose if it is PNG extension, it will not work. Okay. What happened? Save. Image preview will be getting after you click on save. That is what it says. Now your image has been uploaded with some size. Save this. You make sure you're going to check in this. Now if you open the binary file rules and go to actions and view references, you are aware of, right? What is view references? What is view references? View references are going to show you where these rules are being called. Okay, if you have any rule, that rule is being called. What are all the places in PRPC that will be shown to you when you go to view references? This is being called from another rule called text file. This text file they might have used it somewhere else. It depends on your requirement. Let's go ahead now, and this is what the file name that we have image name. So let's go ahead here, go to the section. So you have any control like image? Just wait. These are ODB, right? Image picker. So what is that? We used to have this one, right? This is not proper. Let me go ahead and cancel this and see the icon itself. It should be an image. An image I'm going to give. What is the name of this? Let me give, try this once. It is a trainings is the name of the image that I have given, and then save this. Getting it right. Valid entry for rule 17. Is there an organization? That's okay, but it is there, right? It is uploaded properly, but rule set issues we are getting. What is the name of rule set issue? Valid entry for rule 17. Okay, I'll do one thing. Hang on. I do not want to go with this error now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a section. This image is there in STFM rule set, right? I'll create in STFM rule set one section. I think we already have customer details section, right? Okay, let me create a new section otherwise. Create user interface and then section, test section. That is in version 4 we have created, or version 2? Version 2, 010 to 01, right? Okay, create and open. That's why it is not getting actually. create a section. Just let me show you from the beginning. And you just go ahead and add icon. Take icon. This is the icon that we have. Double click on it. So double click on this and icon source. What is the icon source? Image. Let me give a screenshot. Click on gear icon. Gear icon against image. Let me click on that. Once you click on gear icon here, it will ask you to search for the same what you have created just now. What is that? Click on find. So that it should be able to find if you have given everything correct. Has it found this? Select and click OK. Select this and you click on OK. See, this is how we have to be www-image.extension. You can remember this forever and then click on submit. So now you can add this section wherever you want. Suppose in the harness, top of the screen you want to add, top of the harness rule, you wanted to add this logo. Maybe on the left corner you want to place this section, maybe in the UI that you are designing. Okay, top panel, left panel, middle panel, maybe at the corner, one of the place you want it. If you add this, you will get this logo that is been available displayed there. So whenever you wanted to go ahead and create images up to referring section, I think it should be fine, right? After this, wherever you use this section, this image will be displayed. So wherever, we use this section, the image will be loaded. Okay, will get loaded. Okay, this is clear. So this is how an image can be added into a section by creating it as a binary file role. So most of the times when you get any requirements related to images, you need to remember two things. One is you have to upload this into WebWB app directory and you have to go ahead and give the extension without any dot while creating the rule. While creating the rule, did I give there any dot JPG or directly JPG? It will automatically take the dot while you are calling this into the sections using icon tools. The image size can be anything, it's up to you, depends on your business requirement. Generally, business will provide you the appropriate images, what you have to upload, keeping it in a shared path. From there you can upload. This is clear. So now, is this static or dynamic? This is static design. So most of the times you go with static design. Suppose if you take property reference, then that is dynamic design, but we are not required to see that now.